My name is Kenyon Kanata Brugo. I come from Meru, South Imenti Constituency. I started my farming journey as a tea farmer, but along the way I got into avocado farming, which is more lucrative than tea farming. I planted my first orchard in 2010. Actually, I planted about 100 trees and later planted other orchards around that. Now, how did I get to avocado farming? I got to avocado farming because at one time I came visiting home and met my mother having sold some avocado, and she had only three trees, yet she fetched around 9,000 from one picking. So simply I decided now if I planted 100, probably I'd be getting about 300,000 every year. So I went and bought the first lot of about 120 trees, planted them. And since then, it has become a very profitable business. Okay. Basically, in my farm, you'll find about four different types of avocados. I have the Fuerte variety. Fuerte variety is usually consumed in the Middle East. And the prices for Fuerte are quite low. You can't compare it with us. Fuerte goes for between 7 and 10 shillings a piece. And it's an early maturing fruit. You get most of the fruits from the month of February, and we finish selling Fuerte fruits by the month of June. So, and Fuerte occupies a very large area. It's a very big tree, occupies a very large area. If you are to plant Fuerte, the spacing should not be below 9 meters by 9. That is 9 meters from one tree to another and 9 meters from one line to another. The second variety that I have in my farm is what we call the original ash. Sometimes there's confusion between original and golden ash, but the two are very good. Those are the ones that are fetching the price of between 15 and 20 shillings. You plant them spacing of about 7 meters by 7, so you get more trees in a given area if you are doing the original and golden. There's a third one that we call the giant ash. Giant ash occupies a larger area. It bears very, very huge fruits, but the production is very, very low. You might get as little as 100 fruits or even less per mature tree. And the price for giant ash is not that high. Like this year, the highest price we have received for giant ash was 10 shillings. Now we have another one which is called Picaton. Picaton has got a shape unlike other avocados, more like a gourd. And I think I've not had any Picaton buyers in this area. It's a very rare fruit to... I mean, you rarely get market for Picaton. But now, of course, how do we end up with all this? Because of the mistakes we make when we are buying the seedlings, going to unlicensed and certified nurseries who will sell anything to you in the name of ash. So at the end of the day, you end up with all the varieties. Sometimes you are forced to cut big trees again and re-engraft them. At the moment, I'm harvesting around 90 trees, and 90 trees, I make around 800 plus thousand per year. Of course, avocados are biannual. One time the production is so high, and the next time probably it goes down. But on average, with half an acre, a farmer should be able to make between 700,000 and 1 million when the trees are about the age of 10. Now, it has become so lucrative. Today, we are selling one piece of fruit at the farm gate at 15 shillings. We have companies that are also offering 16 and 17. But what we do is we usually sign contracts with the exporters. This year, I've signed a contract with the Seasons Orchard for 15 shillings per piece. They're the ones who are now selling my fruits or exporting my fruits. Now, we are planning one to have a special general meeting with all the members to discuss the issue of theft, because it's becoming very, very serious. We are working again, like I said, with the administration, and we are also trying to make sure that the fruits are harvested as early as possible, because the longer they stay in the farms, the more the chances of them getting stolen. So actually at the moment our exporter Sisson Sochan has harvested from around 200 farmers, and we hope to finish harvesting the first round of harvesting in the next 1 week. Let me say this without any fear of contradiction and without any doubt. If my farm was bare at the moment, if I didn't have tea and the trees and everything that I have, I would plant avocados in my whole farm. All the 10 acres would be avocados. The ones that I'm harvesting now, 90 trees, though I've got others over 200 that have not reached the harvesting stage, I use less than 20,000 shillings to maintain.
In a year,
because what I do, like last year I applied 5 pickups of manure, one costing me 2,000 shillings, so that is 10,000, and paid driver for the application. We don't spray, I didn't use fertilizers. So probably the cost of now trappers, which is about 200 shillings per trapper. So my total cost for the whole year was less than 20,000. And my total harvest was, it was somewhere near 1M. Now we have a major challenge at the moment. And the major challenge is because of the high price. We are having this fruits being stolen from the farms at night. Last week alone, we had almost 4 cases. We reported them to the police. We reported them to the administration, because it's becoming so rampant. Every time you wake up in the morning and you hear of a farmer who has lost fruits at night. So this is becoming a major challenge for the farmers. Another big challenge that we are facing is from the mindromen. The mindromen, of course, are interested in offering very low prices, some as low as 6 or 7 shillings, exploiting the poor farmers, because you know, there are some farmers who will not be able to wait until the exporter with whom they have signed the contract come to pick. So because of the issues of poverty, they kind of sell their fruits at throw away prices. Of course, as a cooperative, we have a cooperative called the Bogeta West Cooperative Society. We are trying to address those issues to see that we carry everyone along the way. We have so many exporters competing for the fruits. Some of them actually harvest immature fruits. And those who are steering will also not be careful, because it's at night. They won't be able to select exactly what they are steering. And this is affecting our image abroad. Because when we export immature fruits, then in the world market will be looked at as a country that does not export good quality fruits. But the government is addressing the same, because through Agriculture and Food Authority, AFA, we now have an export ban from the month of November to around end of February. Yeah. So during that period, there is no export of Kenyan fruit, to make sure that by the time we open the export again in March, the fruits that we take to the world market are mature.
Yeah. So, now I come at 16. Hey.